that, I don't know, let's say middle and high school students mm-hmm. don't attend school, that they, do they not feel interested? Do they struggle? Do you see a correlation with some of the programs and services you offer and those types of students?
So probably all of the above. It could be as simple as at the beginning of the school year, the parents do not have the wherewithal to provide the children with a backpack full of school supplies. Here's where the community can step in and make sure that they are part of a back to school drive and supply, just as the Children's Services Council does, in partnership with the social workers at the school board. It could be that when they're in school, they're falling behind in school, in class, their grades are falling, they can't keep up. And they really need the services of an after school program that can provide some sort of tutorial support for them. So the CSC funds that in middle, in elementary, and now in high school, again in partnership with the school board. It could be that they're in school and the academic part of it is not satisfying, it's not stimulating enough. Well, the business community has an obligation, or they have a part to play in this, because through Partners in Education, a 501c3 that works in partnership with the school board, they can form a partnership with the school. And like others have done, maybe if they have an automotive shop, provide some sort of support, some sort of additional classes for that. They can provide a mentor for a student who's struggling, and as a business person to say to them, look at me, I now own a business. When I was your age, I struggled and I thought about dropping out, and dropping out is not the thing to do. So again, it really is a partnership that it should be a community-wide partnership to get our kids to stay in school every day, that they should be there.
Okay, thank you. So Laurel and